You just hold that.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
All right.
Joy will come.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
If you just wait up on the Lord, as Isaiah said, you'll realize that joy will come. It's prayer time. May I just say that as we look at the condition of our land, we ought to always be praying. Trouble. On every side. Confusion. We need the Lord. We need Him right now. Listening to the speeches that were being made and the promises that were being made by certain individuals that seeking our votes and wanting to run our country. And I said, how delusional can we be?
Right.
To think that we can fix anything without God. Let me tell you, our country is dealing with the fallout of sin in our land. And I don't care who it is, or I don't care who makes the promise, amen. Can't nobody deal with sin but God. And I know they're talking about the murders, amen, the copycat killers, amen, the child molestation and all of that stuff. I know they keep talking about those things, but those things are just symptoms of the real problem, and the real problem is sin in our land. Mama, if it's ever going to get fixed, amen, only God can fix this problem.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Amen. Not only can He fix the problem that's in our world, amen, but even if you have an individual problem. Amen. That's the thing that I like so much about my God. He's big enough to take care of the world's problem, and at the same time, amen, He can be minute enough to take care of my little issue. Only thing we have to do is just call on Him. Trust Him.
Yes, sir.
Amen. I'm not worried about the troubles, amen, because I know I have a God, amen, that can handle any trouble. Not worried about the sickness, amen. I'm not worried about disease, amen, because I know that I have a God, amen, that's a doctor, amen, that there is no disease that He cannot heal. I'm not worried about drugs and the things that are happening in our streets because I know that same God that watches over you and I is the same God who watches over those in the streets. And just like He changed us, He can change them also. It's prayer time. The Word of God said man ought to always pray and not faint. The Word of God tells us to cast all our cares on Him, because He cares for us. If If there ever was a time we ought to gather around the altar, we need to gather around the altar now. Because we need the Lord. We need the Lord. Like man is becoming more wicked by the day. We do things today, amen, that at one day you never ever would have thought of seeing done by one man. But let me tell you something. When you start putting things in place of God in your life, you're subject to drift off, to be caught up. You're subject to fall to your lowest point.
That's right. That's right.
Do things that are unimaginable.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Say things that are unimaginable. But the thing that I like about my God, amen, no matter how bad you might have messed up, God is just waiting right there for you to return to Him. As we go to the Lord, I ask you pray for our sick and our shut-in. Mother Hill, Sister Hayes, Sister Hatcher, and there are others, and there are some, amen, in the house who, amen, are still battling with health issues. Amen. Pray for them also. Pray for our country. Amen. Pray for one another.
Amen.
And I'm going to add my sister-in-law, Sister Belinda Wilson, to our prayer list. She's the wife of my brother Nathaniel. Amen. She was admitted back into the hospital. Amen. But amen. We know God is able.
Yes.
Amen. We know He can fix it. Amen. And here's the good thing about it. If He chooses not to fix it, He can fix us to where we can handle it. Let us go to the Lord and pray. Master, bless and save me. Lord, the one who made us, Lord, you know all about us. Master, we come to you. Father, we come in humble submission. Father, we come kneeling before your throne of grace. Lord, realizing, Father God, just how much we need you. Master, thank you for allowing us to come to you. Lord, we realize, Father God, in so many ways, Lord, we are unworthy to even call your holy name. But Master, thank you, Father God, because, Lord, you love your grace and your mercy. Lord, thank you for your love that you have, Father, shown to us, Father God, because, Lord, even while we were yet sinners, even while we were yet without strength, Father, you sent your Son down to die for wretched sinners as us. And now, Master, even, Lord, you've given us the privilege, Father God, to call upon your holy name. Father, you said whatever we have need of, you said ask for. In the name of Jesus. And Lord, here we are this morning. Father, I don't know what's on the hearts of your people, Lord God, but I sure know this, Lord, we need you.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Father, so many times, Father God, we feel like, Father God, we're making it on our own, Lord, but Lord, Lord, we need you right now. Father God, life sometimes presents problems that we can't seem to solve. Lord, we need you right now. Father, sometimes we find ourselves in situations, Father God, that we can't get out of. Father, we need you right now. Lord, we know, Father God, that there's nothing that we can do without you. Father, we cannot climb the mountains unless you guide us up. Father, we cannot navigate the valleys of life. Father, unless you take us by the hand and lead us through. And Father, we just cannot make another day without you. And so, Master, here we are this morning.
Yes,
calling on your holy name.
Yes, sir.
Well, Master, we want to lift up our country. Lord, whether we admit it or not, Lord, America is sick. Lord, we need you to heal us. Lord, our children, Father God, face an uncertain future. Lord, we're calling on you right now. Lord, that you will fix it. Lord, that you will cover them. God, that they may live out the days that you have appointed in their lives. Well, Master, we come this morning lifting up these who are gathered around this altar. Lord, I don't know what's on their hearts and their minds, but I'm thankful, Master, you know our hearts. Father, you know our character. And Father, you know everything there is to know about us. Father, you know what we need better than we know ourselves. Lord, I'm asking you, Lord God, to supply us with what we stand in need of. Father, I'm asking you, Father God, if there are those who are burning down, Father, and feel like they can't make it, Master, I'm praying, Father, that you be a burden bearer for them. Father, if there are those, Father God, that have been sick for a long time, Father God, and almost given up hope, Father, I pray that you would be a doctor for them. And Father, for those who can't see their way, Master, I pray that you would be their guide.
Yes,
Father, we need you right now.
Right now.
Master, we ask that you would touch us.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Father, things don't look so well sometimes.
Yes.
Lord, just as long as we know that you got us in your hand.
Yes.
Master, everything is going to be all right. Father, somebody said, I had to lay awake and cry all night long.
All right.
Until my pillow was all wet with tears.
Yes, sir.
Well, Lord God, let them know, Father God, that you will dry their weeping eyes.
Yes, sir.
But Master, come and see about your children.
All right, all right.
Father, we know that, Lord, we cannot do one thing without your hand of mercy.
All right, all right.
Master, we ask in the name of Jesus, you would just touch us. Lord, deliver us.
Lord Jesus.
Father, make us free. Father, for those who've been on the battlefield for a long time, Father, body has become weak. Lord, I pray that you would give them strength.
Jesus.
Lord, for those who feel like, Lord, they're at the end of their road. Father, they can't see no way out, Father. I pray that you will open doors. Lord, let them know that you got all under control. Master, I cannot close this prayer, Father. Lord, unless I tell you thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
For the things that you've already done. Father, thank you because, Lord, we were at our worst. Lord, you were at your best. Thank you, Master, because, Lord, we know it could have been over with a long time ago. Lord, when we fail to do your will, when we fail to follow your word, Father, thank you because you didn't give up on us. But Lord, you sent your only begotten Son. And he shed his blood out on Calvary. Thank you, Lord, for giving us. And Father, accepting us back. Lord, as though we never left you before. Now, Lord, as we come to you, Father, we ask that you would move among your people. Father, somebody needs to see you today. Father, have your way. Father, strengthen us. Build us. Father, keep us. Master, protect us. Lord, we can't even walk, Father, without you holding our hand. Father, we can't make another day. Father, without you providing for us. Father, come see about us. Father, we bless you. Father, we glory in you. Because, Master, we know that it's all because of you that we are here right now. Now, Master, I ask that you would look down among your people. Father, we need to hear a word from you. Lord, I ask you to touch us.
Please, Lord.
I ask you to speak through us. Lord, as we empty ourselves, Lord, fill us with your power. Father, fill us with your holy word. Lord God, that when we get up, Father God, when we have been strengthened, Father, that we won't stop until we reach out for somebody else and tell them of your goodness. Master, have your way. In the name of Jesus, bless all these your children. Come see about them. Take care of their needs like only you can. This is our prayer. This is our praise. Lord, we pray that thy will be done. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Master. Amen. Thank you. I shall drive them. And I will send the sword, the famine, and the pestilence among them, till they be consumed from off the land that I gave unto them and to their fathers. Amen. And you may be seated. Lord, in this vision, ask Jeremiah, what do you see? Jeremiah said, I see two baskets of figs. Amen. This morning, we want to talk from this subject, a lesson from two baskets of figs.
All right.
Amen. A lesson. Amen. Thank you, ushers. From two baskets of figs. Amen. Sometimes God reveals his message to us in the most simplest of forms that many times we miss out on what he is trying to get us to understand. Many times we miss the message God is trying to get to us because we look for him to communicate it to us one way, but yet God chooses another way. And there are times that we miss it because we just don't understand. There are times, amen, that we miss it because we just don't understand when and how God is speaking to us. Or either we get to that point to where we just really don't like his method, nor his message. Well, I want you to understand, regardless as to how we feel, it still doesn't lessen the impact, the content, or the purpose of God's message. Jeremiah here is once again being prepped by God to go to a king and a people that had drawn the ire of God for their idolatrous lifestyle. And the king of Judah at this time was one Zedekiah. Zedekiah was a puppet king that was put into place by Nebuchadnezzar so that he would always have some kind of control or influence over Judah, amen, who was now under Babylonian control. Amen, 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 amen. Jehoiachin, or Jeconiah, the son of Jehoiakim, who followed after God and sought God's direction, had already been exiled with the first wave of Judah by the Babylonians, along with the skilled craftsmen, princes, and, amen, the smiths, the Daniels, the Shadrachs, the Meshachs, and the Abednego, amen. They had already been removed from Judah. In other words, everyone of value and worth and ability, amen, had already been taken to Babylon and employed by Nebuchadnezzar to strengthen Babylon's grasp on the nation around her. And now all that's left in Judah is a wicked puppet king and some wicked and misguided people. Amen. And understand that that they were taken out in the first wave of exile. Those that were taken out were the ones These were, amen, the industrial leaders, amen. These were the ones, amen, who, amen, strive to do their best. Amen, to be obedient to God, amen. These were the ones who tried to be devoted to God, amen. Yet, they were caught up in the judgment of God for the sins of the nation of Israel and Judah.
All right.
Amen, amen. They were innocent to some degree, but yet they were the first ones to be taken because of their relationship with those that defied the presence of God among his people. Amen, amen. As a matter of fact, God classified them in this vision to Jeremiah as the good basket of figs. Amen, 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 amen. And it begs us to question, why does it seem like the innocent suffer along with those that are guilty? Amen, amen, amen. Those that, why is it that those that try to live right are penalized because of a few lawbreakers? Amen, amen. It begs us to question, why is it that, amen, those that try to do the will of God, amen, seem to get caught up, amen, along with those who have forsaken God. Amen. But I come by to tell you that it does rain upon the just as well as the unjust. Amen. The sun does shine upon the good and the evil. Yes, you know what Paul says in Romans chapter 8, verse 28. Paul said, and we know that all things work together.
Yes.
For the good to them that love God.
Yeah.
To them who are the called according to his purpose.
All right.
Amen. Amen. God had already had them removed because God had another plan.
All right.
And another purpose for taking the good basket of figs first. Amen, 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 amen. If you read that 24th chapter, verse 5 to 7, amen, God reveals his plan to Jeremiah, because when God asked Jeremiah, he said, Jeremiah, what is that you see? Amen. Sitting outside the temple. Jeremiah said, I see two baskets of figs. One good and one evil. Amen. And let me just stick this in. Amen. The whole crux to this chapter, amen, is giving us to understand that in every situation, amen, there will be two sides.
Right.
One good and one evil. Amen. 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 And let me tell you something. And just because, amen, you are a good bastard, amen, don't mean, amen, that you are exempt, amen, from the judgment of God, amen, that will come, amen, upon the nation, amen. I understand we are all American.
All right.
Amen. And some of us are good.
Yeah,
and some of us are evil.
Right.
Oh, come on, talk to me, amen. And let me tell you something. Some of us obey God. And some of us are disobedient to God.
Right.
Amen. But let me tell you something. Just because you are one that obey God, amen, don't mean that you won't get caught up.
You're right.
And God's judgment that comes down on America because of the evil fruit.
Right.
Amen. Those that were good, amen, those figs that were the good basket, amen, these, amen, the figs represented the people of Judah, amen, some being good and some not good, some being obedient, some disobedient, some, amen, choosing God, others choosing the way of those countries around them. Amen. God, amen, had another plan, another purpose for taking the good, amen, from amongst the evil.
All right.
Amen. In verse number 5-7, amen, God reveals his plan. Amen. To Jeremiah, God tell Jeremiah, I have sent them out for their own good, says some bad situations, some dangerous, some toxic relationship for our own good. Amen. Yes, we will stay right there until we become like those around us. Amen. 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 Even though it looked like, amen, to the casual eye, amen, you would look at it, amen, and you would feel sorry for that good bunch of fruit, amen, those good people, amen, because they were the first ones to be carried away. Would think, amen, that amen, their goodness came off of them because they were the first one moved. Amen. But I come by to tell you, amen, amen, God revealed to Jeremiah that it was his plan to remove them from amongst that bad seed. Amen, amen, amen. Amen. God said there, he said, I have sent them out for their own good, said the Lord. All right. Amen, amen. I hear us all the time saying, amen, amen. Folks I used to hang out with, amen, I don't hang out with them no more. Right. Amen, amen. But I come to realize, amen, amen, the reason why, amen, is not necessarily because we chose to not hang out with them anymore. Amen. Sometimes God has to step in, amen, and separate us, amen, from toxic folk. Yes, yes, God said to Jeremiah, he said, Jeremiah, not only have I taken them away, have I taken them out of Judah, I will also acknowledge them. I will set my eyes upon them for good. Amen. And not only that, Jeremiah, amen, the same people that you saw leave out in the beginning. He said, I will bring them back again to this land.
All right.
Come out and tell you, in God's own time, after he had purged the land of that righteous element that persists, unless all be infected by it, God will bring his people back to the place of his promise.
All right.
Amen, amen. Let me tell you something. Let me tell you something. Sometimes it's a good thing for God to remove you from the presence of some folk.
All right.
Amen, 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 amen. Even though we like to hang around with them, even though, amen, we like to, amen, fellowship with them, amen. But let me tell you something. There are some folk, amen, that are just not good for you.
All right.
And God knew, amen, that God knew that if I allow this good basket of figs, amen, to hang around with that righteous, the evil basket, amen, that it wouldn't be long before the evil would corrupt the good.
Yes, yes.
God said, I took them out, but don't think they've been forsaken. Because he said, I will always keep an eye on my people.
All right.
Yes, not only will I keep an eye out on them, but after I've gotten rid and moved out this righteous element that has defiled the land, God promised that he would bring his people back.
Right.
Not only will he bring them back, but the Lord said, and I will establish them. I will build them up and not pull them down. I will plant them and not cut them up. Man, God has a plan for those who will be obedient unto him.
All right.
Man, even though, man, we find ourselves sometimes, man, in a bad place,
yeah,
suffering because of the sins of of the field. I want you to know God has not forgotten you. Man, you know, man, sometimes by relation and affiliation, amen, we get grouped into one body. Man, God knows those who are obedient unto Him. And those who are disobedient. Man, God promised Jeremiah. He said, even though you see them, they've been taken away. I want you to know I took them away for their own good. Man, but just as sure as I've taken them away, the Lord promised that He's going to bring them back again. But when I bring them back, I'm going to establish them, and I will bless them. I will build them up, and I will not tear them down. I will plant them, and nobody can pluck them up.
All right.
Not only that, I will give them a new heart.
Yes.
I give them a heart to know me. Know that I am the Lord. And they are my people. And I will be their God. Yes, God has a plan for His people. Yes, we may be caught up, amen, in some of the judgment of some of the folks that we are associated with.
Right.
Let me tell you something. None of us, amen, took a gun and murdered anybody. None of us attacked or ambushed anybody. But because of your relationship, amen, you will come under the same judgment as those that perpetrate against the law. Amen. If you don't believe me, amen, you just walk down the street in the wrong neighborhood. And see when folks look at you strange. They will act strange toward you. And somebody even stop and ask you, what are you doing over here? Yes, there are some good people that get caught up in the judgment of people that do evil works. But isn't it good to know that for those that seek God, and that seek Him with their whole heart, that the God who has made this whole world has made Himself available to those who diligently seek Him.
All right.
Yes. The Apostle Paul will say, Romans chapter 8, verse 31, Paul will say, what shall we say then? To these things, if God be for us, who can be against us? Yes, isn't it a wonderful thing to be able to say that I'm His and He is mine? Situation. driving this evil fix. We cannot be evil. Why Jeremiah said, because they are so evil.
All right.
God asked Jeremiah, what did you see? Jeremiah said, I see two masters of figs. I see one good and I see one evil.
Yeah.
And just as God had a plan for that good basket, God also has a plan for that evil basket.
Yeah.
Amen. I told you the good basket and the figs were caught up in the judgment of God by their relationship with the evil basket. However, God's judgment was to come down on those of the evil basket.
All right.
Because of their disobedience and their idolatrous lifestyle.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Jeremiah, what do you see when you look at that second basket? Jeremiah said, I see evil fruit.
All right.
They're not even fit to be eaten. Because they are so evil. Amen. I come out and tell you, evil only can produce more evil.
Yes.
Amen. We always try to do evil things, amen, to produce a good act. But let me tell you, evil will always bring about more evil.
Right.
Jeremiah, what do you see when you look at that second basket? Well, I see the evil will become worse and worse.
All right.
We can tell by looking at our country today. Mm. Amen. We started out as a country, amen, that was built on our belief in God and religious principles.
All right.
Amen. But since God has blessed us, amen, we found ourselves just like those, that remnant that was still in Judah.
All right.
Amen. Instead of us getting better, amen, we started to become worse and worse.
All right.
Yeah. I even every act of those evil fruit would become worse and worse. Every act would become more devious than the other. Every lie they tell would become more lethal than the other. As a matter of fact, no one will be safe in their path. Yes, they are not good for any relationship. They are disgusting people to be around.
to be eaten because they're only getting worse and worse. But I come out to tell you, just like God had a plan for that good bastard, God also has a plan for the evil. Yes, verse 9 and 10, God said, and I will deliver them to be removed and removed into all the kingdom of the earth for their hurt. In other words, God said, I'm going to remove them from the land. Amen. Remember, God said about the good bastard, he said, I sent them out. But for the evil one, God said, I will remove them. Amen. From all the kingdoms of the earth. All right. Not only will I remove them, but I will, they will be a reproach and a proverb. Amen. They will be a taunt and a curse. And all the places where I shall drive thee. In other words, God is saying that when I deal, when my judgment come upon thee, amen, there will be nowhere that they can go and find relief. Because everywhere they go, amen, they will find, amen, that they are reproached and a proverb. Amen. They will not be able to be comfortable anyway. Amen. But they will be a reproach and a proverb. Man, they will wander around like nomads who have nowhere to call their home. Amen. Everywhere they go, amen, they will never be able to settle down because of the judgment that has come down upon them.
Yeah.
I come out to tell you, God will judge all of the nation.
All right.
Man, even though we may find ourselves sometimes, amen, a byproduct, amen, of the judgment of the evil of men of our color. But I come out and tell you, God knows the righteous. God, not only does he know the righteous, but God knows the ways of the righteous. And God will protect his children. God will keep us even when it looks like, amen, we're in a bad situation. be able to find comfort anywhere. Everywhere they go, they'll never know freedom again. They will be a reproach and a problem. Man, every time somebody speaks of a sorrowful people, they will be the example used as one of sorrow. Not only will they be a reproach and a proverb, but everywhere they lodge, they will be a curse wherever they show up at.
Yeah. All right.
Amen. Don't you know there are some folk, amen, that try to enter into our service. Amen. That are a curse everywhere they go. Amen. Not only that, God said, I shall drive them. Not only will I drive them, but utterly, I will destroy them. He said, I will send the sword, the famine, and the pestilence. I will send them among them till they be consumed from off the land. He said, they're no good to anyone or for anything. So I will send the sword to destroy them off the face of the land. But for that good master, even though they may be displaced for a little while,
all right,
but because of their willingness to seek my face, I'm going to bring them back home. Not only will I bring them back home, but I'm going to set them up
all right.
Better than they were in the beginning. All right. Let me tell you, it don't matter where life may take.
All right.
It don't matter what hardship you might have to endure.
All right.
trouble. And no more troubling folk. That place where trials and tribulations will not affect us anymore. That place with no more tears will have to be shed. Because of a broken heart. I don't know about you. It may be tough sometimes.
Right.
May seem like I'm at the bottom of the pecking order.
All right.
But let me tell you, if you choose God, if you give your life to God, it don't matter how far life may take you now. My God has promised to raise us up and to give us a reward. Every now and then, God has to separate us from some things that will mess us up. Every now and then, God has to move us from some people that will contaminate us with bad attitudes and bad disposition. Every now and then, God has to take us away from some folk that will mess us up because they can't stand to see you naked. But I tell you, if you trust in the Lord and keep your hand in the master's hand, if you believe on the Lord and wait on the Lord, Isaiah said, we shall renew our strength, we shall mount up. Said, I see two baskets. one good, and one not even good to eat. The question is, which basket are you? Are you one that God can say is tasteful, is good?
Yes.
Are you one that he said that I will destroy them? I will send them out, they'll be a byword, they will be a proverb. What basket are you? And can't nobody answer that question for you but you. But I come back to tell you, God is still watching. He's still listening. And he's still recording.
All right.
And here's the key, amen. Amen. When it comes down to it, amen, when you have been evaluated, amen, there will be nothing that you can say that will come to your defense when to God's judgment comes.
Right.
Take a lesson from these two baskets of figs. Being good fruit. What am I talking about, good fruit? I'm talking about one of good works.
Right.
One of good conduct, one of good worth. Good value, amen. One that helps, amen, not hinders. One that picks up, amen, not pull down. One that loves, amen, not lie, amen. One that picks, one that reaches out, amen, not take from. So what did you see, Jeremiah? Jeremiah said, I see two baskets. One good, one worthless. Well, now what basket are you? Amen. God bless you. There is a message. There is a lesson. Amen. Come on, Deacons. Amen. That the Lord has given us. As he speaks to us. Understand, Jeremiah, amen, at this particular time, Jeremiah wasn't too favorable about going back to Judah and talking to those hard-headed folk. Amen. Because Zedekiah had already become angry with him. Not only had Zedekiah became angry with him, amen, even the people abused him. But God reassured him, Jeremiah, judgment day is coming. And those who are obedient, he said, I will establish them.
Yes.
But those who are disobedient, he said, I will destroy them.
Amen.
So what basket are you? What basket are you? Amen. God bless you. May the Lord keep you.
Amen.
Amen. And we stand to offer the invitation of discipleship to you. There may be one who may be walking out of the ark of safety. And you may not have surrendered your life to the Lord. This is your day. This is your hour. Amen. And there may be someone who have maybe gone astray. You can come back to the Lord. Amen. The thing that I like about him, amen, when we come back with our hearts, man, God is, his love is big enough. He'll receive us. And he'll take us back like we never left him. extend the privilege to come to Him. Examine your life. Lord, I want to be pleasing to You. Lord, I want to be obedient to You. Lord, I want to be found in Your favor. And it's quite simple. Choose God. Choose life.
Father, I pray for all those, Father God, who have heard Your word.
Father, and receive your word, Lord, that, Lord, those who have been strengthened, that we will go and strengthen our brethren. Lord, this is our prayer in the name of Jesus. May the grace of our Lord and the sweet communion of his Holy Spirit, we pray that